All right, let's do chapter 5 now.
I want to try so hard to be relaxed when I'm doing this. It's all new to me, you know?
And when I say new, I'm talking about, you know, reading this stuff on video. The truth of thus saying is not new to me, man. Okay. Chapter 5. This is 1 John.
I want to try very hard to be relaxed this way.
Plus, I'm kind of tired, so this is the last chapter. Alright. Everyone who is believing that Yeshua is the Anointed, he has been begotten of the Most High. And everyone who is loving him, who did beget, does also love him who is begotten of him. Okay, that's just another way of saying if we love the Most High, we love our brothers. The two go hand in hand. We can't have one without the other. If we have one, we automatically have the other. Basically, we're saying it's all the same thing. That's what he's saying. So, okay, so, love most high and love our brother. And then I'm going to draw a little spark plug wire to it. Okay. So these are the two new commands that have replaced the old two summaries of the Old Testament command. In this we know that we love the children of the Most High, when we may love the Most High, and his commands we may keep. Is he talking about the Old Testament commands? No. He's talking about the new commandments that he gave. A new command I give unto you. And John says in the early chapters, he says, a new command I give unto you, but it's an old command. Why is it an old command? Because he gave it to them probably a couple years earlier. So they've been, you know, they've known it for a couple years now. So it's old news. So, okay. For this is the love of the Most High, that we may keep his commands, and his commands are not burdensome. Oh, excellent point. His commands are not burdensome. Did we catch that? The law of Moses is a heavy burden that can't be performed. Anybody that's striving to perform the law of Moses is putting themselves under a massive burden. But these new ones, that's why he says his yoke is easy. He says, my yoke is easy, man. Okay. No burden. Equals new command. Okay. Verse 4. Because everyone who is begotten of the Most High does overcome the world. And this is the victory that did overcome the world. Our faith. our faith, the faith, the belief, the knowledge of the sin, the knowledge of the access, the knowledge of the recognition, the knowledge that the Most High came in a man's body, the knowledge of all the work that was done, the knowledge of everything that has to do with the one gospel, the one true gospel. Who is he who is overcoming the world, if not he who is believing that Yeshua is the Son of the Most High? Now, we can believe that Yeshua is the Son of the Most High, but if we don't understand who he is and what he did, that's not salvation. All right? Okay. Verse 6. This one is he who did come through the water and blood, Yeshua the Christ, not in water only, but in the water and the blood, and it is the Spirit that testifieth, because the Spirit is the truth. Okay, he came in the water and the blood, so I need more word for explanation about that, but you know, when I think about the water, I think about he was water baptized, all right? And, you know, water baptism doesn't save us. It's the baptism of the Holy Spirit that saves us. But, you know, another study. Okay, so, and then we have the water, too, when he was pierced in his heart, up on the cross. The soldier pierced him with a spear in his heart, and out flowed water and blood. Living water, the living water, living water, living water, like flesh. When we get our new eternal bodies, it's going to be flesh and bone. There's going to be no blood, right? But in the flesh, it's soft, it's supple, like we see, you know, and it contains water, right? Water. Okay. And the blood, of course, the blood is the blood that's on the mercy seat now. Yeshua's pure blood that was poured out, shed out, drained out of his body. The Most High captured it all, gathered it together, and sprinkled it, splashed it all over the mercy seat. Right? Or just let it run out, however he did it. You know, just let it run out of his hands and So, there's a video of this guy who found the Ark of the Covenant. You know, and I believe he's a fourth vow Jesuit coadjutor, you know, they have all the technology to find this stuff underground, so. But, you know, the placement of that Ark was, that Ark was placed right underneath the ground where it was put. Years before, that Ark was placed right underneath the ground where Yeshua died on the cross. So when his blood drained out, it went down into the cracks of the rocks, into the ground, into the underground cave where that Ark was hidden, and it landed right on top of the Ark, the mercy seat. So, and then the guy who found it, they did blood tests on the blood, and they found that the blood only showed the chromosome for the woman. And all of us regular people, we both have the chromosome of the man and the woman in our blood, right? That tells us that the father side of the blood, it was perfect, right? It didn't have that fallen nature chromosome in it, right? So anyway, because because three are who are testifying in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit, and these three are one, and they all agree. Okay, I need to do more studies on those to get more explanation for them, but we can probably get the basic gist of it. If we receive the testimony of men, look at this. How's this for talking about testimony? If we receive the testimony of men, the testimony of the Most High is greater. Because this is the testimony of the Most High, that he has testified concerning his blood. In other words, he's saying, you know, the testimony of men. Okay. Apostle John is giving the testimony. He says, I saw him. We walked among him. We know about his gospel and everything. I'm telling you about it. Right? He says, but the testimony of the Most High is even greater. And then he goes on and says, because this is the testimony of the Most High, that he has testified concerning his Son. Okay, what's the testimony? There are three who testify: the Spirit, and the water, and the blood. The Spirit, and the water, and the blood testify that the Most High testify that the testimony of the Most High is greater, because this is the testimony of the Most High, that he has testified concerning his Son. So he's saying this is the testimony of the Most High. What is this? This is those three things. So those three things is the testimony of the Most High that has testified concerning his Son. Okay? The Spirit, the water, and the blood. We know he had perfect blood, right? The water, need more than the Spirit. His Spirit, you know, I know what his Spirit is, but applying it to this, I need more study on that. Okay, so, verse 10. He who is believing in the Son of the Most High has the testimony in himself. So in ourself we have the Spirit. Oh, okay. So we have three that are testifying on earth, and three that are testifying in the heavens. In the heavens we have the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. In the earth we have the Spirit, the water, and the blood. Okay. So I need to do more. I need to listen to my teacher on that one. So he's said it before. I just need to go over it again. Okay, so let's see here. I'm watching these currency pairs. They're starting to break to the downside. We had a 5 minute. We have a 5 minute ABC pattern starting right here on the pound. But the thing's like powerful in strength right now. It's red powerful on the Hercules meter. So it's probably just a small retrace. But the euro dollar has been weak today. It's just like no strength at all. Whipsawed during the trade, the news event, and I lost big on that one. I've been losing this week, man. Taking some dumb trades. Not dumb trades, but just not stopping myself out, and then throwing a bunch of money on to try to recover it, and then the trade just keeps going against me. That's all right. That's all right. I'm still good. I still have some money left. So this new margin that they did, you know, 10-50-to-1 margin. It's been a real big help, man. It's like a major tool for, you know, it keeps us from betting too big. And if I would have known how margin worked in the beginning, I would think maybe I would have went for the lower margin just as a disciplinary action on me, because we have to